recorded. Thanks, Brittany. Our next guest from Ben Franklin Technology Partners is Wayne Bars, Director of Entrepreneurial Services. Wayne, welcome to Focus.
Thanks for having us, Laura.
In 1983, when Ben Franklin started in the Lehigh Valley, the climate was much, much different. Tell us how this program got started.
Well, you're right. I mean, the program got started back in the early 80s there, where Pennsylvania, Ohio, Michigan, all of the northeastern states were really beginning to lose a lot of the manufacturing industrial jobs. They were losing them to the southern United States and to Mexico. We were facing increased international competition. And Pennsylvania and other states decided to start investing in new technology companies that were beginning to emerge in new technologies. And the Ben Franklin program was Pennsylvania's version of that.
How does a company get involved with you?
Well, after 30 years now and a lot of successes, most people find us by word of mouth, by reputation, and certainly you know, the kind of work that we do here in the community and opportunities like this to talk about what we do. I think people have come to know Ben Franklin as a source for entrepreneurial talent and energy, access to capital, access to mentoring, and obviously our Tech Ventures incubator on the Mountaintop campus at Lehigh.
And so what doors are open when a company gets support from Ben Franklin?
Well, often, excuse me, when companies have just found us, usually it's just the founders and maybe some friends and family have invested in the company a little bit. What Ben Franklin provides is that first stamp of approval on the company. So the founders have to convince us that there's a business plan that has a chance for success, and that it's not just some great invention or new technology, but there's actually a commercialization plan that could be realized. And so what we'll do is vet that company. We provide access to an enormous network of former entrepreneurs and advisors of all types, attorneys, accountants, regulatory affairs people, et cetera, that are in our network that have worked with us for many years, and also perhaps most importantly is access to capital. Certainly Ben Franklin can invest in these companies directly, but also we have connections to the venture capital, angel capital community that operate on the East Coast here.
And in my research, I came across a figure that for every dollar spent on these companies, the return is over $3 of investment into the economy.
It's true. We like to say that we're not just helping to create jobs, but we're creating jobs in a profitable way for the state. And so that number that you cite is the result of studies that have been done that are really just measuring the impact of wage taxes that employees at Ben Franklin funded companies are paying to the state. And so that doesn't even begin to measure just the sheer number of jobs that we've helped to create, the great types of some of the life-saving companies that, you know, those technologies that we're working with that you're going to hear a little bit more about on this show. So that number is a great metric to use that measures the impact sort of from our program today.
And as you mentioned, we are really exploring biomedical companies in today's show, but they're not the only kind of companies that you serve. What is a good fit for Ben Franklin? What kind of company is a good fit there?
We're really looking for companies that are developing what we refer to as proprietary technology. And so we're not looking for retail-oriented companies or more locally-oriented companies that are really just serving a local population. We're looking for companies that have a potential for a global impact and that are advancing some type of technology, and it's diverse. So while we'll be hearing about life science, we're involved in and have been for 30 years, software companies, used to be called enterprise software. More recently, it's cloud-based software. Mobile application development, a lot of business-to-business types of applications in our software work, but we're also involved in advanced electronics, advanced materials, alternative energy projects. It's a very diverse place up on the mountain.
Wayne, thank you so much for sharing this great information with our viewers.
My pleasure.
Well, for many, the